Good evening, everyone. Welcome to Tuesday Spark. Remember, it's words of information, words of inspiration, and words that may incite or spark something in your mind. Listen, I'm not trying to tell you what to think. I just want you to think. So let's spark it up. So here's some announcements I want you to remember. Remember, on Sunday, we still have worship at 9 a.m. You can find us on the Village Facebook page. Tune in to us. Get up, invite your friends. Look, do a little watch party. That's 9 a.m. And the service is not long. But maybe just get up, get yourself going, worship with us, invite some other people. If you happen to miss it, it'll be on YouTube. But don't miss it. And then on Wednesday, we have prayer in the morning. So don't miss prayer because you want to be there for us. And, you know, 6:15, wake your partner up, wake your neighbor up, and come and be with us. And, of course, next Tuesday, we'll be back here at Tuesday Spark. A few other things I want you to remember, and that is, if you get a chance on Wednesday, go to High Noon. That's Pastor Kevin Hart's show that he does on his Facebook page called Pastor Kevin Hart. You can reach him there. Sometimes I'm on, and sometimes I'm not. But he has a good show. Check him out. I also want to thank all the family and friends of the Village for your prayers, number one, your financial support, and various kinds of ways you assist us, and you are such a wonderful people and friends. Thank you so much. Thank you for helping us support the Plummer Elementary School and its principal, Fuller. And we certainly need to pray for our children this coming school year that they'll be safe, and the teachers and the staff. Also, some of you have been giving and helping us. We want to sort of close the technology gap. We have a couple of college students who want to help this coming fall to have a good laptop so they can go to school with. So you can go on the Village website or our Facebook page, and you can give through Givelify or Cash App. So we appreciate that. Remember, our doors may be closed, but the ministry of the Village continues to be done. Listen, tune in. I want you to come with me tonight. And if you got at the bottom of your page, if you share this with some of your friends and bring them on with us, and so they can hear what I want to talk about tonight. Tonight I want to talk about Black August. You're probably figuring out, what in the world is Black August? I know. There's a lot of things that we're starting to learn as our eyes are coming open. But listen, this is a month of remembrance and resistance and righteous rebellion. So in the midst of COVID-19 pandemic, protests against police brutality, racist policies, pathetic politicians, which we have many of them, and protests for equity and justice, dismantling of racist policies, protections being restored to the Voting Rights Act of 1965, proper care for the poor, payment in the form of reparations for 241 years of free labor called slavery, and then all the years leading up to the present. And also Jim and Jane Crow, we went through post-Reconstruction, the Nixon era, the Reagan era, and the Bush era, and now, of course, this era. We have now Black codes, redlining, education inequality, religious co-option for the sole purpose of justifying and maintaining a sinful, ungodly system of slavery, especially white evangelicals and the Catholic Church, gentrification, a new form of redlining, and the beat goes on. So on this Black August 2020, I want you to remember to resist and have some righteous rebellion. Look, August is a month of meaning, of repression and radical resistance, of injustice and divine justice, of repression and righteous rebellion, of individual and collective efforts to free the slaves and break the chains that bind us. The spirit of Black August moves through the centuries of Black, Indian, and multicultural resistance. It's an emblem of the spirit of freedom. Mamiya Abdul-Jabbar, that's what he said. But here is some context, though, for some background of Black August. Some of you have been fighting the ravages of the prison industrial complex for years. I used to hear that term. So what are they talking about, the prison industrial complex? Well, it's the prison system that's elaborate, from the courts to the prisons that are all across this country, right here in D.C. If you happen to go to prison here, there is no prison here anymore. They'll hold you here for a minute, but once you get sentenced, you'll get sent anywhere in the country. So there's a real system. It's a complex system in a sense, but it can be broken. For some of you, though, you've been in this battle and you understand and you know of a man named George Jackson. He's a source of inspiration and discipline. Over 40 years ago, George Jackson challenged us. And he said this. He said, settle your quarrels, come together, understand the reality of our situation, understand that fascism is already here, that people are dying who could be saved. The generations more will die or live poor, butchered half lives if you fail to act. Do what you must be done. Discover your humanity and your love of revolution. Then he says, pass on a torch, join us, give your life for the people. This was said on August the 21st, 1971. And then Jackson was assassinated by guards at San Quentin Prison during a prison rebellion. So Black August, it originated in California in their penal system to honor the fallen freedom fighters, Jonathan Jackson, George Jackson, William Christmas, James McLean, Cartera Golden. Jonathan Jackson was gunned down outside the Marion County, California courthouse on August the 7th, 1970, as he attempted to liberate three other imprisoned Black liberation fighters, James McLean and William Christmas and Rochelle McGee. Rochelle McGee was a sole survivor of that armed liberation attempt. He was the former co-defendant of Angela Davis, who's still living. He had been locked up, listen to this, for 38 years. At the time of his death, 45 years later, most of it spent in solitary confinement. George Jackson was assassinated by prison guards during a Black prison rebellion in San Quentin, August the 21st, 1971. Three prison guards were also killed during the rebellion, and prison officials charged six Black and Latino prisoners with the death of those guards, and they are famously, or some people say infamously, called the Six Brothers, who became known as the San Quentin Six. It's a very interesting thing. And so when that happened, Black August in particular, it was started, you know, after this assassination of George Jackson. Cotero was a leading force in the formation of Black August, particularly its historical and its ideological formation. And he started it sort of to keep alive his memory, but it was a way to of sort of honoring these revolutionary people and never forgetting them. And it was a way to deal with what had happened, because the reason why George was killed was a way for the prison to eliminate his leadership and destroy resistance. Haven't we heard that story so many times? So how did they celebrate, or better yet, acknowledge Black August? Well, this is what the brothers did in prison, and it's been going on now, it's spilling out to the public. Brothers would, in the prison who participated in the collective founding of Black August wore Black armbands on their left arm. They studied revolutionary works, focusing on the works of George Jackson, because he was a writer as well while he was in prison. And brothers did not listen to the radio or watch television in August. Additionally, they didn't eat or drink anything from sunup to sundown. And loud and boastful behavior was not allowed. The brothers did not support the prison's canteen. The use of drugs and alcoholic beverages was prohibited, and the brothers held daily exercises, because during Black August, emphasis is placed on sacrifice, fortitude, and discipline. Wow. Sacrifice, fortitude, and discipline. Black August is a time to remember the principles of unity, self-sacrifice, political education, physical training, and resistance. I'll say that again. So Black August is a time to remember the principles of unity, self-sacrifice, political education, physical training, and resistance. So here's some things that they studied and remember during Black August. They would study American history, so they understood what the empire was about, what was going on, how it functioned, how it kept suppressing us as Black people. They would also study first Africans who were brought here to Jamestown as slaves in 1619. They would look at the Underground Railroad, which started in August the 2nd, 1850. March on Washington in August of 1963. Gabriel Prosser's 1800 slave rebellion occurred on August the 30th. Nat Turner planned and executed a slave rebellion that commenced on August the 21st, 1831. The Watts Rebellion in California was in August of 1965. and on August 18, 1971, Provisional Government of the Republic New Africa was raided by Mississippi police and FBI agents. The Move family in Philadelphia, some of you probably forgot about, was bombed by the police on August the 8th, 1978. And further, it is a time of birth. Black August has been a time to commemorate our collective grief. Think about it this year, 2020. There's over 150,000 people who've died from the coronavirus. And a high percentage of those are Black people. Think about the number of Black people who are in prison, who can't get out, as Trump lets out his cronies. And they're in prison. They're not only dying because they're in prison, they're dying because we're in a pandemic. Think about the number of Blacks who are shot in the street. Yes, some of them are perpetrated by their own brothers and sisters, but sometimes we don't understand what's the real cause of all this that's going on. So this is a time to commemorate sort of this grief that we have, get some clarity, rage, rebellion, mighty waves of popular uprising against the ravages of white supremacy and anti-Black racism are flooding the streets even today, rising within and outside the prison walls and reverberating through communities and institutions. Look at Portland. These are white mothers who are coming to the aid of their children who were brutalized by the police for protesting peacefully and also by these sort of interesting, nefarious individuals that Trump sent in. But these are white mothers who, they got beat up and tear gassed as well. So there's something afoot here. Listen, centuries of enslavement, subjugation exist, and presently it has become intolerable. Black Lives Matter said, look, we ain't taking it no more. These yet to be United States continues to wield violence and force against Black people in forms of mass criminalization, incarceration, repression, militarized police brutality, willful neglect and discrimination. COVID-19 has only uncovered and amplified the disparities that were already there. So I lift up Black August like they have done since 1971. Remembrance, resistance, and righteous rebellion. So Black people, resist in order to survive. You want to survive, but you need to resist. And like generations of ancestors before, to fundamentally alter what is going on, we have to collectively come together and we have to demand what we want. Listen, there's a legacy of Black August. It is a time of reverence to honor the political prisoners, freedom fighters, martyrs of Black freedom struggle. It's an awesome time for us to enrich ourselves with our own history, our history of resistance. Think about what has happened to the Haitian Revolution, to the Watts Rebellion, and the Ferguson Uprising. And Black August is a reminder of power in unity and a mandate to continue to struggle together and to work together. It's important. So it's time to reflect, to learn, to unlearn, to advance the righteous rebellion towards Black liberation. So listen, I want you just to listen for a moment and catch this. There is a tradition of fasting. Can you believe that? Black August fasting teaches us self-discipline, a conscious fast. They would often fast from 6 a.m. to 6 p.m. Think about it. What will you sacrifice? What will you do during this Black August that will make a difference? Everyone needs to be involved. This is Tuesday Spark. I'm your host, Dr. Tate. Remember, all it takes is a spark to light a fire. Good evening.